friends, good morning. So in our next tutorial, as we discussed in earlier tutorial, this I want to customize this portion. How I can customize? I want to show this clearly here. This, how can I show this? See here, clearly I want to show this data with the spaces and all. So here, if you want to customize that, here you can customize for that. See here, this image I want to show in 100 by 100, so then it should be, image should be in a, like a direction. Then here, this I'm changing as match parent, and this also I'm changing as match parent. And here I want to show, instead of that this 1 kg 2 kg, I want to change this as some names, different names, so that it can be little bit attraction here. So that is tomato. So tomato, brinjal, potato, like onion, and the next to mirchi. Next, something palak. I want to show like this little bit lengthy data here. For here also I want to use like this. So what happened here, if it is a little more data, then it can be little bit attraction for the page. So like this. Like this I want to do this. So here then, so here it's, so for this I'm giving you as some margin and all. So I'm giving you this margin as 10 dp. Also I'm making this padding as 10 dp. I'm making this little bit attraction. So this same I'm applying for remaining two as well. So like this I'm applying this, so that now the data can be shown in a proper way. So now also for this every this thing I want to make one separate box for that, so that already we know in a drawable folder we can create one separate this drawable resource file. I'm creating drawable resource file for this border. I want to create a border, so just border. So defaultly this border file as came with as a selector, but I want to change this as a shape. Then once I change this as a shape, here I want to specify some shape, that is I want to show here rectangular shape. Then I am adding here that is a stroke property, just I want outer line, so that line width I am taking as a 1 dp. then color for the line is I am taking this as a this color, primary color. Done. So then now this here I want that for every item separate by this. So here background at the red drawable border, just I applied that border for this. So how this border can be applicable, this is done. So here border came for this. Now we can able to, I'm running this application now. First we can see, then we can go with the next step, how this apply the listener for this. Here like I want to apply the listeners as for the WhatsApp, like image one action and other text, other apart from the remaining place I want to show different this, so that we can see how it happens this. See now, it should be in a attraction like this it came. So but here now this is done. Here I want to take here one more thing here, this I want to take here a relative layout here. I want to take here relative layout to make that update clearly on this. So relative layout, and this is not a that one, I'm changing this And here also border is not required for this. Now see, I'm running this application. Yes, here it's off of fire scheme. We need to control that. This is required. Like see, here it's set of properties. Now, for this also here, I'm giving you as some margin 10 dp. Then the boxes, we can feel that, okay, all are should be in a proper alignment. So 10 dp. So just I'm running this application now. We can able to check this now in a proper way. See, now this is like this. Now I want to apply listeners, one listener for this, one listener for this. So how to apply that listener for this? So I want to apply that listeners here clearly for this. So first I want to apply listener for image here. Directly I'm applying the listener for image here. So binding dot image dot set on click listener, then new view dot on click listener, done. So now here just I want to write in this today just how to apply listener, then we can see next steps in this. Just I put hi. See, now this listener is working or not. And the second portion, I want to apply this listener for this particular portion. See, now I'm clicking on this hi. But I want this apart from the image space, this entire one, I want this listener. If that case here, don't apply listener for the text views. You can apply listener for the this layout. For this layout, not this layout, this layout. Because this layout is occupying, apart from the image space, remaining space is occupied by this only. So this you can make this as a different case. So here now I'm applying here this for this ID that is linear. I'm applying this ID as a linear. So then here come here now you can apply simply here binding dot linear dot set on click listener new view dot on click listener, then here toast along with the text, whatever the text I am displaying this. So that is here binding dot price dot get text. I want to get the text from that I want to convert into to string. This is now I'm taking the data, I'm converting that into here this. Now see, I'm running this application. We can able to see this what happening here. Now this is just I'm running this. Now we can able to check here now what is the output of this. See, now I'm clicking on this image, it's showing here apart from the image space like this. Here we are showing this price like this, it shows this. Since this is about this recycler view, in this there are a lot of variants are there that we can discuss in our next tutorial. To get more updates, please subscribe this. Thank you.